Senator Evan Bayh, latest Democratic member to say goodbye. What do you make of goodbye, Mr. Bayh, saying goodbye?
I say good riddance.
Because?
You know, because here's a guy who stood up there and said, I love serving the people of Indiana, but I don't like Congress. Well, I don't think he was serving the people. You know, if you're talking about the common man, he's a corporatist. That's the problem. They keep saying he's a centrist. He's not. He's a corporatist. You know, he's not serving the common man. And the reason why Congress doesn't work is because of Democrats like him. I mean, I assume the Republicans are going to be obstructionists. But, you know, at one point there was only 40 of them. The reason why they were able to block stuff is because they were able to pick off Democrats just like Evan Bayh. Like, Obama wanted to raise the amount of money that people making over $250,000 could declare as a tax deduction, just back to what Reagan, that socialist, had it at, right? Okay, that would have paid for health care. Well, Evan Bayh joined the Republicans to block that. Same thing with the estate tax. You know, they wanted to reinstate it for people. The top 0.2% of the wealthiest people, not 2%, 0.2%. Well, that was too much for Evan Bayh. So for him to say he's working for the people of Indiana, he's not working for the people of Indiana. He's working for corporations. He'll become a lobbyist now, which is what he was before.
What do you make of CNN's poll?
I understand he's a very nice guy.
Yeah, well, he appreciates all the compliments. A new CNN poll shows only 34% think that most members of Congress deserve re-election. 51% say their own member deserves re-election.
Yeah, well, that's the problem, isn't it? Is that everybody
hates Congress except their own congressman, so they keep reelecting.
Right. And pork, we've got to get rid of that, except for the project in my district. You know, the politicians are no prize, but the people stink. They really do.
The people?
Absolutely.
Us?
Yes. Not you and I, Larry, and of course the people watching us now. Those are bright people, but I mean the others out there. Yeah, because, you know, they
You said 70% of Americans aren't crazy. You're saying 30% are.
I don't know
the
when I said
stink,
that.
30% are crazy.
Well,
why
I
do
probably
you mean
said
we stink?
70% sounds like the statistic we had during the Clinton impeachment. 70% were behind Clinton.
Because
they don't know what they want. They're contradictory. You know, the teabaggers in that crowd, they're very upset, for example, about this deficit we have. We have to get this deficit under control. How are we going to do that? Tax cuts. Which, of course, is only going to increase the deficit, you know. Oh, so we should cut stuff because we have the... Yes, we should cut, but not the Defense Department and not Social Security and not Medicare. Well, that's 80% of it.
So you know, what do they want, then?
Exactly. They want both. They want new jails and new schools and services, and they want to pay for it with tax cuts. You know, they just don't make any sense. Jobs. Why isn't the president getting us jobs? Oh, so you want another stimulus bill? No. Are you kidding? That's socialism. We can't have that. You know,
The Wall Street Journal just reported that five prominent Republicans wanted stimulus for their areas.
Of course. They reflect that hypocrisy.
What do you make of... Now, Obama's job approval rating is now 49%. You have criticized Obama,
who you firmly
supported.
Yes.
What happened?
Well, he had a bad freshman year, as many of us did in college. But I certainly hope things are going to get better now. But I don't know. I mean, he still doesn't seem to get it, that you can't win this with a kiss. You know, he still wants this bipartisanship that is never going to happen. I think he sometimes believes that he is the kind of guy who can persuade people to do anything. I mean, during the campaign, the Republicans did accuse him of that a number of times, of being the Messiah and the one and believing his own publicity. I don't know if that's not... I'm starting to believe it could be true, because if he thinks at this late date that he can get them in a room, it's going to change, we're going to put it on C-SPAN, you know, maybe some of that will change something. But, you know, it's the job of Party B to block the agenda of Party A. What he has to do, I think, is do what Roosevelt did when he came in. He didn't want to be friends with anybody. He said about the bankers, I welcome their hatred. I welcome their hatred because they're not serving the interests of the American people.
So you want him to get tough?
Get tough and Well, of course, I do want him to get tough. And stop doing what Democrats always do, which is try to curry favor with people who are never going to be behind them anyway. For example, this spending freeze that he announced, what a typical Democratic idea. It doesn't really solve the problem. It's not enough to put a dent in the problem, because, of course, they're not going to touch the Pentagon or anything like that. So it's not going to fix the problem. The Republicans only laugh at it. It doesn't win any of them over, and it alienates his own base. You know, the Democrats never curry favor with their own base. A year ago, or when he won the election, Obama finally had a base of people. I mean, my God, he won Indiana. He won North Carolina. He won Virginia, traditional red states. It's all gone now. Those people are disillusioned.
You said it's not what you voted for.
It's not. That's not what I stood in line at the voting booth for. I want my hour back.
Do you think it might change?
Yes, I do. I think presidents have learning curves. I mean, Kennedy certainly did. Mm-hmm. Many of them do not have good first years. But what bothers me is that unlike certain presidents, Reagan comes to mind, who in his first year took the pain. Remember the economy the first year?
Yeah.
You know, he did, you know, it was not a good first year for him, popularity-wise.
He had very low polls.
Right. Take the pain in the first year. He should have done that. He talked about the other day in an interview, you know, I'd rather be
one-term
president. Well, to make that statement, you have to be doing some bold things. You can't make that statement, oh, I'm going to be a one-termer, I'll take that because I'm making the tough decisions. No, you're not. Do some bold stuff, then you could talk about one term.